I just plugged in the USB drive we reformatted in the last video, and I'm typing LSBLK. We see we have two partitions on the SDB drive. I will unmount those two partitions with umount/dev/sdb1 and umount/dev/sdb2. And typing LSBLK again shows that the two partitions are unmounted. There are two popular command line tools for disk partitioning. They are fdisk and parted. In this video, we're going to use parted. We'll take a look at fdisk in a future tutorial. We need to have root privileges to work with the parted command, so I will start the command with sudo and then type parted. Since we did not tell parted which disk we wanted to work with, it defaulted to the first disk it found, which is dev/sda. That is definitely not the drive I want to work with. So I'm going to quit out of this by typing quit. I'm going to clear the screen by typing clear. I'm going to type sudo parted again, but this time I'm going to add on /dev/sdb. And notice I'm not typing sdb1. I'm typing sdb to tell parted I want to work with the entire SDB drive. Pressing enter. Now I see that I'm using /dev/sdb, and that is the drive that we want to work with. Now I'm in the parted prompt. I see a little welcome message that says I can type help to see a list of commands. So I will type help. And here I see a list of commands, and a lot of these are what we're going to use in this video. We're going to use the print to display partition information. We're going to use RM number to delete the partitions that are currently there. We're going to use mkpart to create a partition. We will use resizePart to shrink our fat partition. And then we will use mkpart again to create our second Linux partition. So we're going to do the same thing we did in the last video, only this time from the command line. We'll start off by typing print, and that shows us some general disk information, and then the two partitions created in the last video. Our FAT32 partition is partition number 1, and our EXT4 partition is partition number 2. I'm going to remove the FAT32 partition with RM1, and then I'm going to type print to show that it's gone. Now I'll remove partition number 2 with RM2, and then I'll print that out to show that there are now no partitions on this USB drive. Now I want to create the FAT32 partition, just like we did in the last video, and I'll do that with mkpart for make partition. Now it's asking us for a partition type, primary or extended. What is a partition type? We didn't have this question when we used the GUI partition creator. Well, actually, we did have that option in the GUI screen. Here's a picture of the create a partition from the GUI screen, and we see there is a checkbox for extended partition. We did not check the checkbox in the last video. We made our partition a primary partition in the last video by not checking that checkbox, so I will make this partition a primary partition here as well. We'll go over the difference between primary and extended partitions in the next video. Now it's asking us for a file system type. We want FAT32. And now it's asking us, where do we want to start this partition? We want to start it at the beginning, so I will type in 1MB. Now it's asking us, where do we want this partition to end? I will use 100%, use up all of the free space on this disk. Pressing enter, and our partition is created. Let's make sure it was created by typing print, and we see our partition right there. We have a single FAT partition using all of the space on this USB drive. Now from here, I'm going to type help mkpart for help with the mkpart command that we just used. The first thing that it shows us is that we could have typed all of the options on one line. Since I only typed mkpart, parted went into interactive mode to help me complete the rest of the command, but I could have typed all the parts on a single line and hit enter. We'll do that when we create our Linux partition. Looking at the next line of help, we see part type, primary, logical, extended. We'll talk about that in the next video. Then we see fs type, and it lists all the types that we can format the partitions to. We are only using FAT32 and EXT4 in this video. Then we see start and end for the partition disk locations. We can type a number or the percentage we wanted to use. I'll use both in this video. But while doing some research for this video, I saw some people recommending percentages over the memory locations. Now these last lines of the help are very important. It says mkpart makes a partition without creating a new file system on that partition. What this means is parted has created a partition and the partition information says the file system on this partition is FAT32. But inside the partition, parted has not created a file system. That's something that we, the command line users, will have to do. So let's do that right now. I'm going to quit out of parted. The command to make a file system is mkfs, but we will need root privileges to use this command. So I will start this with sudo, then mkfs, then a period, and the file system we want this to be in this case, which is FAT. And then we want to give it the option of uppercase F32 for the FAT32 option. Then we want to give it the partition that we want formatted, which is /dev/sdb1. And pressing enter, it made our file system for us. Okay, let's go back into parted with sudo parted dev/sdb. And I'll type print just to show what we have right now. And we see the single partition, which is FAT32. Now what I want to do is resize this partition to shrink it down to make room for our Linux partition. So I will type resize part, and I want this to be for partition number 1. And I want it to end at, I'm going to make it 300 megabytes. So I want to reduce this one by 300. So instead of 999 MB, I want this to be 699 MB. Now, I could also have typed -300 MB to free up 300 megabytes, but I chose to use the ending megabytes. It's giving us a warning. Do I want to continue? Yes. And now when I type print, we see that our ending megabyte is 699 MB. Now I want to create our second partition, our Linux partition, on a single line command. And now we know the format that parted is expecting. So I will type mkpart and then primary. We're making this one also a primary partition, just like we did the last video. We want this to be a file type of ext4. And we want this to start at 699 MB. And we want this to end at 100%. So it will use all the free space available after 699 MB. Pressing enter, it created it. I'm going to type print. And there we see our two partitions. The first one, FAT32, and our second one, EXT4. Now we've created our Linux partition, but we haven't yet created the file system on that partition. So I will need to quit out of here. And now I want to make that file system, the ext4 file system. So I'll type sudo mkfs.ext4/dev/sdb2. Pressing enter. Now it's telling us that it created an ext4 file system on there already, which is interesting since the help screen was telling us that it did not create one. So I'm not sure if the documentation's off or not, but I'm going to proceed anyway and write this ext4 partition over the ext partition that's already there. And now it's creating the file system. Now, it would be preferable if they just would have added that mkfs command as part of the mkpart command, but they didn't, so we had to manually add in the file system. Now, what if in parted, I said the file system is FAT32, and then I added an ext4 file system in place of that on a Linux machine? That won't be a problem for the most part. There may be a program or two that does not like that, but for the most part, it should work on a Linux computer. On a Windows computer, Windows will not be able to read that ext4 partition and want to reformat it so it can read it. I'm going to go back into parted and type print. And we see our two partitions are created, the first one showing a 699 megabyte FAT32 partition, and the second a 300 megabyte Linux ext4 partition, just like we did in the previous video, only this time from the command line. In the next video, we're going to look at disk label partition table for the Linux command line.